What is good, y'all? Welcome back to yet again another episode of J.I. Productions. It's your boy J.I. and I'm back at it again with another banger for you guys. Now, as you guys can see by the title and the thumbnail, in today's video, we will be going over the five things that I hate about my 2016 Mustang GT. Let's get straight into it. All right, you guys. So, now I'm going to be 100% honest with you guys. These five things are literally, I believe, only on my car. So don't think that, you know what I'm saying, oh, these are five things that you would see on every S550 Mustang, because that's not the case. These are just my five pet peeves with my car in general, just my car. Like, talking about this one right here, five things I don't like about it. Coming in hot at number one, right? So it's a 2016. It's the base model. It's a 6-speed manual. Now, with that being said, since it's a base model, the interior is not the best. Coming from a 2SS to a base model Mustang, I'm not gonna lie, has been probably the hardest part about the transition. So coming in, like, in specific from the interior, I guess we could say number one is gonna be the interior of the car. But my reasons as to why I don't like the interior of the car is as follows. Number one, this little plastic piece right here is broken. That pisses me the hell off. Like, bro, that is one of my biggest pet peeves about this car. If you guys know me, you know I'm super, like, OCD about my cars and the interior. I really care about the interior of cars, and seeing that every time I get in and out of the vehicle really sucks. Now, staying on the topic of the seats, bro, these seats are freaking trash. I can't even lie. The bolstering on these seats, it just feels like, it makes you feel uncomfortable. And I was talking to my boy, Block Boy Lando, and we were talking about the seats and the lumbar support. So, as you guys can see, this button right here, I don't know how well it's gonna pick up on camera, but that controls the lumbar of the seats. So basically, when you push it to the right, it'll sink the back part of the seat back, and when you push it to the left, it'll push it out. Now, with that being said, that lumbar support is literally trash, bro. It feels terrible. I really hate it. I can't even lie. Like, it makes you sit so uncomfortably in the seat, especially if you have the 6-speed manual. Whenever you're reaching for the clutch and stuff like that, when this hits your back, it's just, I ain't gonna lie, I'd be hella uncomfortable. So number one is definitely gonna be the interior, because I ain't gonna lie, the seats are trash, and I hate that small tiny screen. It's not even touchscreen. What the hell? Number two, and I ain't even gonna lie, this is hella consistent with Hazel. When I had Hazel, I don't know if you guys remember, but back in the day, I did a five things I hate about my Camaro V6, well, my V6 Camaro, and it was the stock wheels. I'm not even gonna lie, Mustangs have some really nice stock wheels, like the premium package wheels that come with the performance pack. I ain't even gonna lie, them joints are fire. But these right here, I don't even know what the hell Ford was thinking with these joints. They got like the aluminum finish on the face, but then each spoke has like this, like, brushed, like, I don't even know what to call that, but it's just not, it ain't it, you know what I'm saying? So the wheels are definitely trash. I hate them. Now, going into number three, it's gonna have to be the calipers, bro. I'm gonna keep it a buck. Coming from a 2SS, I had the Brembos in the front and also in the rear. Now, coming to the Mustang, what is that? That caliper looks like it's supposed to be for like a hydro or some shit. That joint is small as hell. And then we got the super big meaty boys in the front. I think these are Brembos. I'm not 100% sure. Y'all let me know down in the comment section down below, because I ain't gonna lie, y'all know, probably know more about Mustangs than I do. I'm just getting into the platform. It's gonna be a fun, I'm just here for the ride, honestly. Now, number four, bro. Number four is going to have to be this. Like, I don't even know what to call this. What the hell do you call that? It's damn sure not a spoiler. Well, it's damn sure not a wing. I guess it's supposed to be like a little lip spoiler. I'm happy that they threw one in, but the fact that it was just, it's this thin, it's just like, bro, you can't even tell that the car has one on it when you're standing from afar. You feel me? So it's definitely gonna be this joint right here. I ain't even gonna cap. That spoiler gotta go. Now, the last and final thing. Now, this is, I ain't even gonna lie, this is one of the most pettiest things ever, but it really bugs me, and I already have a solution for it, like a part coming to fix the issue. It's gonna have to be the amber on the side of the headlight and on the turn signal. I just feel like, you guys can see that amber right there. There's an amber light and then there's a clear light. I personally feel like this should just be one full LED white switchback mook. And then this little side amber thing right here, I don't even know what the hell you would call that. I guess it's a side marker for the front. That being amber as well also throws it off. Not just because my car is black, but amber to me is just tacky. I'm gonna keep it a buck. It's just tacky to me, bro. Like, I don't know. You walking around the car, it's all black, you know, got a couple of silver parts with the 5.0 and the GT badges. And then you get to the headlight, and it's like, what the hell is that? You know what I'm saying? So that's probably gonna be the fifth thing that I hate, honestly, about this car, is the fact that it's 2021. I mean, the car came out in 2015. Well, this one is a 2016, so it's probably made like late 2015. But still, LED lights were definitely out when these joints were made, and I know Ford knows damn well they could do better than this. You know what I'm saying? But that's actually gonna do it for the five things that I hate about this car. If all five of these things were missing from this car, it would be perfect. I guarantee you. So y'all, with all of that said, man, those are the five things that I dislike about this car, my personal car. Some of them goes for all S550s, but majority of the things are specific to my car. If you guys know a quick fix or any way I can fix that little cover thing on the seat, please drop it down in the comment section down below for the kid, because honestly, it drives me crazy every time I see it. But yeah, man, you guys let me know your five things in the comment section down below. Also, let me know by giving this video a big thumbs up if you guys want to see the five things I love about my Mustang. I definitely will make that video for you guys. If you guys smash the like button right now, you gotta smash the like button, and I promise you, if you smash it, I'll wait for you. I'm waiting. While you're there, since we're waiting anyway, if you're not subscribed, go ahead and smash that subscribe button too. And if the post notification bell is not on, make sure you turn that on for the kid. That way you can stay up to date with all of the vlogs. Every time I drop a video, you'll get a notification to your phone, and you can literally just click on that notification like you would a text message, and it'll take you straight to the YouTube. But with all of that being said, man, that's actually gonna wrap it up for this video. If you guys are new to the channel, like I said, make sure you smash that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications to join the JI squad, man. But yeah, man, that's gonna be it for this one. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.